guys excited to be back here at home and chance to turn things around a little bit?
We are. You know, a week ago, we had won two in a row, and we're fairly confident. And when you lose two in a row and then you go through what we went through, a little bit, you know, the guys are a little bit fragile, but we'll get them back right. They'll be ready to go.
What are those discussions? What are those discussions like? I mean, the fragility of it.
Well, that's any college basketball season. But I think with what happened to Reggie and Abdul, that has impacted our guys, and it's good to be back with them, and it's good to be back home. And our guys want to do well. And there's a lot of games left to be played.
Can you update us on them?
Yeah, they went through that cryotherapy session as we did our whole team, and unfortunately they were injured from it. They did absolutely nothing wrong, nor did we. And we're trying to get some answers as to how something that happened. You know, as the head coach, I'm certainly first and foremost concerned about them, and they're going to be okay. But it is rather serious. It's nothing long term. And then administration is involved to find out as to what happened and why something went wrong.
I know that's kind of controversial. You know, what's the cryotherapy is kind of a controversial thing just from Google searches and that, is it? You know, what was the thinking?
Well, I don't know. The thinking is that multiple NBA teams use it, multiple professional teams. It's used in college athletics. It's used by athletes all over. And it's a recovery system that is NBA teams use. So I don't know that there's anything controversial over it. I know that we had an incident, and we're trying to deal with it.
Is it the first time you guys have used it?
Yes.
Did you look into the dangers at all of doing?
Well, we look into everything. We try to put our guys in the best position to be successful. So the rest of the guys used it. There's nothing wrong. I know the women used it. Don't expect anything like this to happen. Unfortunately, it did, and we're looking into it. Because our guys did. And any other questions will be answered by administration. Whose decision what?
Whose decision was to bring it in?
To bring it in? Well, my strength coach looks into it and asked if we could use it, and I said, sure, we can use it if everything checks off. He's talked to multiple people in the profession that use it. It's been positive, and that's what we've done.
Is there a timetable for those guys? I know it's
kind
of a weird injury.
Reggie's doing much better. Abdul's was a little bit more severe. There's going to be some recovery time here. But the main thing is that those guys are going to be okay in the long run.
Weeks, days?
Probably a couple weeks. We'll go from there. And right now, though, we've got to concentrate on the game. Any questions about the game? None?
What are your expectations going into the weekend?
Well, we've got to play better. We've really struggled. We've struggled to score for the most part, even in league play, but we've really defended and rebounded well. We just last week at Drake, I felt we did a great job defending them, but we struggled to score. At Bradley, we hung in there for a half. Obviously, Alizé was in big foul trouble, but we didn't respond well the second half. But as I said, our guys went through a lot in 24 games. And as I said, they didn't do anything wrong. We didn't do anything wrong. And now we got to recover. We had a good practice yesterday. We have to have another one today, and we got to be ready to play. We've been good at home, and we got to hope that that continues. Well, I don't know if there's been any route. I think if you follow, we have struggled on the perimeter. There's no doubt we've struggled on the perimeter. JD has been really solid of late. He's probably at that point or at that two guard spot. He's been pretty good. He scored the ball better, and then he struggled the other night. Rhodes has been pretty consistent with what he's given us. And then obviously Alizé had a tough week, but we need him to score. We have not shot the ball. If you look at the numbers, I don't know if there's any room or anything. We have not shot the ball like we're capable. We think we've got guys that can make shots, so hopefully they'll start to go in.
At the halfway point of the valley, is there kind of a reflection point of we need to do better all around? Is there something specific they're talking about besides scoring the ball?
You want to be better in all areas, but you can only defend for so long, and you have to be able to score enough points. Now, obviously, we've lost a little bit of a scoring punch, so other guys are going to have to step up. But I think that's the main thing, being a little bit better offensively. And I don't think there's wholesale changes. A guy like Ryan Kretlow, we believe he can make shots. We believe Ronnie can make shots. We know that Alizé can score. I think the thing that impressed me the most about last week was even at Drake, with Alizé struggling like that, we still had a chance, and our defense kept us in there.
With these guys out for a few weeks, how does that affect your depth and even asking what other guys have to do?
It affects us. There's no doubt it affects us. But, most teams will lose guys for various reasons, and then you have to adjust. So we still have enough. We're still in position. As I said, we're not a great team. We're trying to become one. We've got a great opportunity in front of us tomorrow with Southern.
Challenges they bring to the table.
They're good. They've been without some guys, but I think just overall they can score the basketball. They've got guys that can make threes. They've got a big kid inside in Pippen that can score, and they're tough. They'll defend you. They've got good players. Armand Fletcher has really elevated his game. Lloyd has always been a very good player. There's challenges. There's challenges in every game, but hopefully they're looking at us saying we present some challenges. I know for most people, everything is centered around trying to stop Alizé, and that's fine. As I said, one person can't do it. We have to have others step up. We know that he'll continue to play. He will play better. He'll get himself out of it. A week ago, he was coming off the best game of his career, 24 and whatever it was. He was phenomenal. So. Confidence can be a funny thing, guys. You're one made shot away. You're one game away from being pretty confident. And then guess what? You're one missed shot or you're one loss away from not being very confident. So a week ago, we felt pretty good about where we're at. Things have changed. I think that's just going to be the season. There are no easy games.
There's no secrets either this time of year.
No, I think that's new. At this time of the year, you get through the halfway point, people have you figured out. And I know for us, they're kind of daring us to make shots from the outside. We believe that we got guys that can make shots, and hopefully we'll make them pay if that continues to happen.
You talked about how if you're an average team, you'll be at the bottom of the valley.
Yeah.
To be at this point, halfway through, and a couple freak injuries, a couple road losses, what can a big performance tomorrow do for this team the second half of the conference?
Well, I mean, it's no different than the two prior road games that we lost, at Evansville and at Illinois State. We came back and got right. As I said, the situation with our two players, and that's what we are concerned about, is our players and their health and their well-being, and they're good kids. They didn't do anything wrong. That's what everyone should be concerned about, okay? And what happened to us with that situation Tuesday, I think it impacted us, right? But our guys are good guys. They're coachable. They want to bounce back.